where I was held hostage. This is where my property was stolen. Actually called earlier. My name is Korryn Gaines. I was held here for a couple days, from the 10th to, I want to say, like the 12th. And my property is missing. I have some important paperwork that I don't have.
Officer Paul Connell.
Mm-hmm.
He was the arresting officer.
Right.
So I have a message for him.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you know how soon?
Officer Paul Connell.
Mm-hmm.
He was the arresting officer.
Right.
So I have a message for him.
Okay. Do you know how soon? Because I'm trying to get my paperwork together. I have court dates and things, and that's right. Very important paperwork that I need.
Right, because I looked in all of our property and the property back.
Mm-hmm.
Holding everywhere.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure it isn't. It was specifically taken out of here. Discharge papers and a court order. And like I said,
did Dunbar transport you, or did he transport you?
Here.
From here to Kate.
Actually, what was his name? Officer Richardson?
Richardson?
Big guy? He actually traded places with what was his name? I'm sorry?
When you were transported.
I'm sorry?
When you were transported.
It was about 1:30. Yeah, it was about 1:30 in the morning. Hold up my fucking process. So, look at him. Hello.
Okay. Your discharge papers?
In a court order. I believe you were the one that showed it to me.
The discharge papers. Mm-hmm. What's your last name?
Gaines.
Okay. That paperwork was in the locker. You say you never got any of that stuff?
No, sir.
Okay. Let me see if I know you're talking about now. You was here when I was here. Okay. Let me see if I can find it.
Please.
We put it in the property.
Okay.
It gets forwarded to, when you went to the courthouse, you got released on your own recognizance.
Yes, sir.
Okay. When you released, you had, I don't know what property you had. I can't remember the actual property you had other than a court document. The officer.
I do have the discharge papers.
You got released on your own recognizance.
Yes, sir.
Okay. When you released. You had, I don't know what property you had. I can't remember the actual property you had other than a court document. The officer.
I do have the discharge papers from that night, and that's only because it was given to the officer that transported me to see the commissioner.
Right. So basically, you went to the hospital twice.
Yes, sir, the day I came in.
So you went to the hospital discharge papers, what you're asking?
Yes, from the first day. I went to the hospital twice, so I should have two discharge papers.
So you want the discharge paper for the first time?
For the first time, and I would like the court order that you showed me. That
you have no court order at all? They gave
no.
me nothing?
No.
Okay, let me see if I can find it, okay?
Okay. Right. Yeah, they court ordered my fingerprints. And he the one who showed me the signature page. And they know I need that. Sweet cheese. Mm-hmm. Just continue to waste my time.
That's another way to obtain this shit, right?
They shouldn't have stole it from me.
I'm just saying.
Absolutely. They can, I can retain it, but so can they. The same way they got it so fast, they can get the judge to call it and or fax it over to them. That's how they did it to get it. So I don't even understand why they running around looking for it, when they can just call and get that shit faxed. It's very simple. They shouldn't have stole it. That would be them wasting more of my time if I gotta go to extra.
Okay, Sergeant Cunay is a supervisor for Officer
O'Connor. I'm sorry, could you spell his name?
C-O-U-G-N-E-T. He's a supervisor.
Okay,
that shift is gone for the day. There's another shift that's working now. I'm asked checking with the supervisor for that shift to look into the paperwork to see if he can find it. Waiting for a call back from him to let me know if they have that paperwork that you're looking for.
Okay, how long will that be taking?
He told me he'll call me right back. He's in the process of looking for that.
Okay,
it could be 5 minutes. 15 minutes, 20 minutes, I don't know specifically.
Okay.
But he did tell me he was going to call me back.
Okay, great. I'll be happy to stand here and wait for that call back.
Sure. Are you going to have a seat?
Sure.
All right.
Officer that arrested you.
Mm-hmm.
Also, Connor's schedule. I checked the schedule. Also, Connor will not come back till Thursday. All they can find is just your arrest page. Nothing to do with the paperwork that you mentioned. We normally don't keep copies of lockers. Some officers keep copies attached to the paperwork, but he checked what information he had there. He did not see any discharge papers. What I'm going to give you, so you know my name, so we talked the other day. Also, Connell's scheduled to come in on Thursday.
Okay.
You call this number, this is just precinct, but again, he comes in on Thursday, that's also common, that's his ID number.
Okay.
This is my name and ID number, the desk officer that you spoke to.
Is his supervisor on today?
No, but that's it. The shift, right now, the shift is a new shift. Even though I leave at a certain time, supervisor come in like an hour and a half early. So this supervisor is gone.
Okay.
That whole shift.
Is there any supervisor that I can
see? Time, supervisor come in like an hour and a half early.
So
this supervisor is gone.
Okay.
That whole shift.
Is there any supervisor that I can speak to?
A supervisor?
Yes.
You don't want to speak to, wait for the supervisor, because they're not going to be able to do
it. I don't want to wait for anything.
Well, you
I have
to.
I have an appointment to seek legal counsel, and this is something that was given to me when I was here. And I was told specifically, I actually watched it. This was the female cop that helped me use the bathroom. Mm-hmm. She showed me when I came out to give my fingerprints that she was putting my court order along with my belongings.
Correct.
Okay, mm-hmm. Now the fact that I don't have that, mm-hmm. and that was the last place, mm-hmm. you guys were the only ones that were dealing with my paperwork and my belongings.
Did you get your belongings back?
No, I didn't, not all of them.
What property were you missing?
My court order.
Okay, besides, let's get that part about it.
Did you get your belongings
back?
No, I didn't, not all of them.
What property were you missing?
My court order.
Okay, besides, let's get that part about it. Physical property, what property were you missing?
Those are the things that were my property that are missing.
The
court order and also the discharge.
So the documents. So
absolutely.
Clothing, rings, jewelry, you got everything, whatever you have with you. You did receive that. You're talking about the documents.
Exactly. Exactly.
Okay.
And this is something that you're saying that he comes in Thursday. Mm-hmm. I have court dates already. Okay? And I need to talk to my lawyer, and these are things that my lawyer has to have. So unless you guys are guaranteeing me that my court dates and everything are gonna stop until I receive those documents, so that I can have the amount, the correct amount of time to have, seek my counsel, then that's fine. If you can guarantee that, when, because my court dates are in April.
The only dealings I have with you personally is me working.
Exactly, that's why I'm trying to ask you. Exactly, that's why I'm asking for a supervisor. Someone that can address what's going on. If you can't address what's going on, then I need to, no, you're not addressing it. You're telling me that I have to wait, and that's not acceptable.
Okay, would I be a supervisor, okay?
Thank you.
For you to contact the legal division, if you have any shit, because she said, I just was about, just talked to the supervisor, they told me to give you the number to legal, you can contact legal, have your attorney call our legal section, and they can work it out when we got that.
Okay, so why isn't the supervisor here to speak with me?
Well, I'm the middleman, okay? Right. I don't make the decision. I'm like,
okay, but even that answer is unacceptable. We just went through this. Why should I have to take my time out to do that when my stuff was here? Okay, that's still wasting my time. And this is the time that I should be sitting with my lawyer and discussing how we're going to go about this case. You guys are, you're basically sabotaging my case with doing this.
I have nothing to do with you. When I spoke to you when you was here last time, I was totally honest with you.
I understand you have nothing to do with this. That's why I'm asking you for your superior.
And I did that. If I go to my supervisor and they tell me to tell you something, last time I was totally honest with you.
I understand you have nothing to do with this. That's why I'm asking you for your superior.
And I did that. If I go to my supervisor and they tell me to tell you something, that's my boss.
And you can go back. Okay, and I'm your boss. You guys are a public servant, okay? Now I'm asking, I'm requesting, sure, yes. I'm requesting you to get your supervisor here so that I can speak with him directly. Okay? Okay. Can I hear her say that?
Man, she's not going.
Because I'm sure that you don't. I'm sure she doesn't want you to say that on this camera. I know she don't want you to speak for her. So if she can come out here and she can deny my request to speak with her, I'm not going to take your word for it.
Okay. That's fine. I'm just going to say that. Told me to give you that information, and I'm doing what she told me.
Okay, and can you ask her to make sure, I want to get that on camera, that she does not want to speak with me, because I can't take your word for it, because when we go to court, she can easily say that she did not. And you are a credible person, okay? I'm trying to speak to a suit. Absolutely not.
Okay.
Absolutely not.
Well, ma'am, I'll say, you have a wonderful day. There's nothing else. She's not coming out to talk to you. I'm just telling you she's not. So
okay.
That's the number. You have my name.
Okay. So are you? So you're saying that you guys don't have the court order and you don't have the discharge papers?
I'm telling you what I've told you earlier. Mm-hmm. Everything I told you, and I addressed the issue with my supervisor.
Okay.
The supervisor told me to have you.
And I have yet to speak to that supervisor.
And that supervisor told me to reiterate that information.
And who is her supervisor? I would like to speak to her supervisor.
Excuse me?
I would like to speak to her supervisor. Whoever's over her head, that's who I need to speak to, because obviously you or her aren't aware of your job title or what you're supposed to be doing right now. Okay, when someone asks or demands to speak to your supervisor, you have to speak to that supervisor.
And that supervisor told me to reiterate that information.
And who is her supervisor? I would like to speak to her supervisor.
Excuse me?
I would like to speak to her supervisor. Whoever's over her head, that's who I need to speak to, because obviously you or her aren't aware of your job title or what you're supposed to be doing right now. Okay, when someone asks or demands to speak to your supervisor, and your supervisor, not only do you not get her out here, she is refusing to come out here, you guys are going against everything that you guys stand for. Okay, do you remember the oath that you took?
Ma'am,
do you? Does she know it? No, wait a minute. Listen, that's unacceptable. Okay, we already know that. I'm just reiterating what I'm saying. I'm in the middle. So she's not going to come out. Okay. Okay.
She's not going to come out.
Go back and address the issue with my supervisor.
Okay, well, that's fine.
This is what she told me.
Okay.
When this young lady was here last time, her and I spoke. I was very fair with her. She knows me. The whole time I was here.
Mm-hmm.
Totally fair with her.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to her. I mean, the whole time she was here.
Mm-hmm.
The whole time she
knows. And you don't have anything to do. Exactly.
And she's going to speak to the school.
And I am entitled to that.
I'm not saying that she's not going to get the information.
Right.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying she may get everything she's asking of.
Right.
However, the officer who was the arresting officer is not into that.
That has nothing to do with my belongings. I'm asking for his supervisor. I've asked for your supervisor. No supervisor has come out and talked to me. Okay, now you're sitting here. You don't have anything to do with this. So you can't offer me the correct.
When I'm being told to do something, I'm following.
Exactly. And I specifically asked you, who is her supervisor?
I like I just said, if you want, I will go back and I will see if the shift commander will come back to talk to you.
Absolutely. Now, and I would like to know who her supervisor is. And what is her name?
I'll write that for you.
Please, thank you. Because she needs to be reported, seeing as though that she won't report out here to when her presence is being demanded. Yeah, she needs to. She clearly doesn't know what she's doing.
Okay, this is Sergeant Steyen.
Okay.
That's the name. That's her ID number. 5134.
Is there any reason why she hasn't come on speech to
her? Because, like I said, I'm just being told.
What?
I don't know, but when you're employed,
why,
she
what,
just
we,
told
we
me,
wouldn't come
I don't question if this is what she told me. She said to give the information to her call legal. I'm just reiterating what I was being told.
Okay.
I will go back. I will talk to the shifter, let her know that the shifter, you want to talk to the shifter, man.
Absolutely.
They may or may not come out and talk to you.
Okay.
And it's going to be over.
But I just want to make it be known that I am asking to speak with them.
It was addressed the first time, but I'll go back again.
Okay, thank you.
You're